So guys, in this video, I'll show you guys how you can set up recently viewed product section on free themes of Shopify. So if you're using Dawn theme, Fresh theme, Sense theme, or any of the free theme of Shopify, you can set up a section where all of the recently viewed products will be displayed. Currently, there is no feature available in free themes of Shopify. In this video tutorial, I'll walk you through step-by-step process on how you can add that section. And now question should be that why you should add a recently viewed section when you have you may also like section in themes and lots of other features. So my suggestion is to add that section because it's good to have recently viewed products all the times on the product page because it takes a little time for making a purchase decision, and it's good to have the section which is always displaying the product which they lastly visited on their store. So in this video, I'll show you guys a step-by-step process on how you can add that section and try to increase the purchase decision of your users and try to increase sales of your store. So that's how the recently viewed product section will look like. And this is a desktop display. And now let me switch to the mobile version. So here's how it will look in mobile. And all of these products are recently viewed, and these products are extracted through cookies in session. So let me clear the cookies and let me show you guys how it collects the product name, images, and all of that kind of stuff. So I'm going to clear up my cookies and sessions so you guys can see how it will look when someone freshly visited the product page, right? Okay, on application tab, from local storage, okay, I'll need to minimize this. And these are all of the local storage values which are showing up. Now I need to find the recently viewed, here it is. So all of the recently viewed products are being saved in this key of the local storage on your browser. And now let me delete that. And now if I hit refresh, you can see that it's only displaying one single product, that because that's the only product which I have visited after clearing the local storage. Okay, now let me visit some more products and show you guys how the remaining products will fill up the gap. Okay, now click on all products, and now I'm going to visit some of the products to see how the section will look like when I visit other products and how it saves the products on the recently viewed section. Okay, now click on gray t-shirt, and now you can see the recently viewed gray t-shirt is showing up as the second product. Now let's do that with two more products. Let's visit one of the hat product, and when I scroll down, you can see it added the third product. Let's do the fourth one, and let's add in the t-shirt, the red color t-shirt. And here you go. Now you can see all of the four products are showing up. Now, when I tried to visit the fifth product, it will just remove the first one and then add the fifth one to the fourth number, right? So it will not display the layout of the section and it will not be disturbed. Okay, so let's try doing with the fifth product. So as you can see, I have four products for now: blue t-shirt, gray t-shirt, river hat, and the t-shirt. Now, if I visit the fifth one, let's do the leather jacket product. Scroll down. Now you can see it's showing up the leather jacket product as the fourth one and remove the first product which was showing up. And if I visit the mobile version, you can see that's how the section shows up. It's completely aligned and looks good on mobile and desktop version. Okay, now let me show you guys how you can add that on your store, on your Dawn theme. I'm gonna use the Dawn theme. You can use any free theme. Okay, so let's go to the development store and then click on themes. And I have already added the fresh version of Dawn 11.0. I'm going to publish that. And now let me preview that. And if I now go to any of the product page, you can see that it doesn't have any section below the main product page. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll just add the code and show you guys how you can do that on your site, right? So let me close the extra tab here. And now what I'm gonna do, I'll click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have the backup of your theme. In case you mess up anything, don't blame me that I gave you the wrong code. I always want you guys to have the backup of your theme. Okay, click on edit code. And guys, before I show you guys how to add the code, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because that's the only thing which I'm asking you guys to do, and it will help me a lot to create more content for you guys. Okay, so let's create a new snippet. So scroll down and then click on this snippet folder, click on this arrow, and then click on add a new snippet and name it recently viewed. Okay. And then click on done. Okay, the recently viewed snippet has been added. Make sure there's no code before adding the code which I'm going to provide you guys. And the code is here with me, and I'm going to press command A and then command C to copy all of the code and paste the code on this file. And once the code is pasted, it's safe. And now second step to render this snippet on your main-product.liquid file. So we have created a snippet. Now we need to render it on the product file. And let me explain this code a little to you guys. So it's pulling up the objects from Shopify Liquid and putting them on the JS variable. As you can see, it's putting the product title, and there's a product image, product price, product URL. So no matter whatever theme you use, it's gonna work on all of the themes. I'm a little unsure about the paid theme because I haven't tested that on the paid theme. It might not work on the paid theme, but you can try and let me know in the comments below if that works for you. Okay, and it's a big code, right? And that's the number of products which it's gonna show on this variable. And then it will use the local storage JavaScript option to view the products. Me and my team have took some of the pieces of the code which are available in Shopify community and optimized it to make it look good on the desktop version and the mobile version just for you guys, and also creating this video to show you guys how you can add that on your store. Okay, now once this snippet is created, I'm gonna go to main-product.liquid file. Now in your main-product.liquid file, search for product-media and -model. So that's what you have to search, product-media-model. And what I'm gonna do, I'll add a line break and render our recently viewed -liquid snippet which we created, and just render it. And now recently viewed is rendered. Okay, let me double check the spelling, recently dash viewed. Okay, now hit save, and don't worry about the code guys, you will find all of the code in the YouTube video description where there's a blog post link. All you have to do is just click on that link and copy and paste the code, and this code is free of cost and you don't have to pay anything for that. Okay, now what I'm gonna do, I'll go to my product page by clicking on preview store, and let's go to blue t-shirt, and here you go. As you can see, so these four products which are showing up are basically being saved when I showed you guys initially. So what I'm gonna do, remove it from my network, from my browser storage. So when I click on application tab, you can see there's a local storage, and these are all the keys which are saved. So I'm going to remove the recently viewed key and then close my developer tools and then hit refresh. Now that's how it will look to your visitor when they visit the product for the product page for the first time. And when they keep visiting the products, they'll keep showing the recently viewed section up there. So it's a good addition to your theme. You should definitely have it if you want to increase the number of sales and purchases on your Shopify store. Okay guys, so that's it for the video. I hope you guys liked it. If you do, please let me know in the comment below what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.